Thank you. actually passed away earlier this year, which is sad for our euphonium players because it is the first concerto composed specifically for euphonium. So that's pretty cool. It was actually composed in 1972, which makes the euphonium as a solo instrument pretty young, pretty recent, relatively. And I don't know if you have noticed, maybe you've noticed, but my favorite things is the title of my recital. It's a themed recital, and I really wanted my last performance here at ASU to be representative of me, everything I've learned, and all of the music that has influenced me throughout my life. And the Horowitz Euphonium Concerto is one of them, not just because it is a standard euphonium repertoire, but it was also on a CD that my husband Mitchell gave me back when we were just friends. I liked him. So whenever I listened to it, about him. So, yeah, it has a special place in my heart, so that's why I wanted to perform it on my senior recital. And for my next piece, I'm joined by my sister, Laura. She played bassoon in high school, but that was a couple years ago, and she so graciously agreed to pick it up again to play with me on this duet in my recital. We're going to be playing Sleepers Awake. It's my favorite Bach cantata, and I arranged it for euphonium and bassoon. I hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you.
It is a cello sonata or a bassoon sonata. It's a low instrument sonata by Michel Corrette. It's Baroque. And I discovered it because I was doing a music history project on the serpent, which is the ancestor of the euphonium and the tuba. It's made of wood. It looks like a serpent. It's a Baroque Renaissance instrument, but I found a video of a serpent player playing that, and I listened to it a bunch because it was the recording I was using for my presentation, and I just really fell in love with the piece. So that's why I decided to include it on this recital. I hope you liked it. The next piece I'm going to play involves some equipment, as you can see, and another instrument, as you can see. It is Bourbon Street Parade, which is a trad jazz standard. A lot of you probably know it, but I had the opportunity to be in a trad jazz lab group where I learned some stuff about that type of music and improvising, and I had a lot of fun. So I wanted to share my rendition of this tune with you all tonight, using these electronics to perform with myself. So we hope the electronics end up work.
Thank you.
After will be cookies that Mitchell's mom made. So they're homemade, and I know they're going to be delicious. So please do. Oh, also, thank you to Dr. Svoboda, my teacher, and thank you to my parents, and thank you to Gail, my pianist, and just, yeah, thank you all for coming. Mm-hmm.